Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2247. Can you return all VLOOKUP values? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gellin. Two questions came up in my seminar in Appleton, Wisconsin last week. Both related. They said, hey, how do we return all VLOOKUPs? All right, in this case, like J1199 has a bunch of matches and they want to return them all. And my first question whenever anyone asks me this is, well, what do you want to do with the matches? Are they numbers that you want to add up, or is it text that you want to concatenate? And it's funny, two questions in the same seminar, one person wanted to add them up and the other person wanted to concatenate the results. So let's take a look at both of these. Check down in the YouTube description for a table of contents where you can jump to the other one if you want to see the result of the text. Okay, so first thing, if we want to add them all up, we're not going to use VLOOKUP at all. We're going to use a function called SUMIF or SUMIFS, which is going to sum everything that matches this item. So SUMIFS, here's the numerical values that we want to sum, and I'll press F4 to lock that down. That way, as I copy this down, it's going to keep pointing to the same range. And then we want to go check and see if the job number in column A, again F4 there, is equal to the value to the left of us, in this case E2. And as we copy that down, we will see the total for each item. Let's just do a little check here. J1199999. The total is 25,365. All right, so that's working. If it's numbers and you want to get all the numbers and add them up, switch over to SUMIF or SUMIFS. But if it's text, all right, now this function is new in Office 365 in February 2017. So if you have Excel 2016 or Excel 2013 or Excel 2010 or any of those older ones, you're not going to have this function. It's a function called TEXTJOIN. TEXTJOIN. This is another function from Joe McDade, who just brought us all those great dynamic array formulas at Ignite in 2018. And Joe made sure the TEXTJOIN would work with arrays, which is really great. So the delimiter here is going to be comma space. Ignore empty. Definitely, we want to ignore empty here because we're going to generate a lot of empties in this next part of the if statement. If that item over in A2, F4, is equal to this job number here, then I want the corresponding item from column C, F4. Otherwise, I want quote, quote, like that. Close that if statement. Close the text join. Do I have to press Control Shift Enter? No, I do not. It brings me all of the products that match like that. All right, so returning all VLOOKUPs. If we want to sum them, yes. If we want to concatenate them, yes. All right, now there's one other possibility here. When people ask me if they can return all VLOOKUPs, it might be an issue where we want to look up each of these costs here and figure out the handling cost and then sum them all up. Like, I don't want to put a VLOOKUP here and a VLOOKUP here and a VLOOKUP here and a VLOOKUP here. I just want to do them all together. And in that case, we're going to use the sum function and then the old lookup function. Lookup says that we're going to look up all of these values in column B. I don't need F4 here because I'm not copying it anywhere. Comma. Here's our lookup table. Close paren, close the sum, and it goes out and does each individual VLOOKUP and then sums them all like that. Well, hey, all of these topics are in my book, Mr. Excel Live, the 54 Greatest Tips of All Time. Click that I in the top right-hand corner to learn more. So the question is, can you return all VLOOKUPs? Well, sort of, but not actually using VLOOKUP. We're either going to use SUMIF, TEXTJOIN, or SUM, or LOOKUP to solve it. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. You know, all right, I've been talking about these dynamic arrays for a week. I wanted to do one video where I didn't touch on dynamic arrays because I know a lot of people don't have them yet. But here we are. It's the outtake. You know, these aren't alphabetical, and this would be so much better if we could sort them. And if you happen to have the new dynamic arrays, you could send this into the sort function, sort like this, and press Enter, and now the results will be sorted like that. You know, even this formula could get better with the dynamic arrays. The lookup requires you use the comma true. What if you wanted to use a comma false? We could change that to a VLOOKUP, look up all of this text into that table, comma to comma. In this case, I am going to use true, but in another case, you might use false. Control Shift Enter, no, it's just going to work, right? Dynamic arrays coming out in early 2019 will solve so many problems. Thanks for hanging out through the outtake here. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.